Chapter 8 is all about something called external direct products. It's kind of a strange concept at first glance, but is pretty handy in terms of a new way of generating lots of examples of groups, and also taking groups we're familiar with, especially the U groups, the U of N groups, and figuring out what they're isomorphic to. And you start by saying, okay, I've got two groups, call them G1 and G2. And I'd like to take these two groups, which may or may not be related to each other, and I'd like to somehow combine them to make a new group. Our book uses the following notation for this. They put a plus sign with a circle around it to denote this new group. It's called the external direct product of G1 and G2. External direct product of G1 and G2. Though I will tell you that other books don't use this notation. Other books, instead of putting a plus sign with a circle around it, funnily enough, they use a time symbol, a cross. Other books, not every other book, but some other books, use that notation for the exact same thing. Yeah, it is kind of funny that our book still calls this a product, but uses a plus sign with a circle around it. Does our book ever use this notation? Yes, but in another way than what we're about to say here. In either case, as a set, this is the set of all ordered pairs of elements from capital G1 and capital G2. Objects of the form G1 comma G2 with parentheses around them, an ordered pair with the property that little g1 is in capital G1 and little g2 is in capital G2. Where, this is important, this is going to be a group. If it's going to be a group, I have to define the group operation. It's more than just a set. There's also a group operation. What is the group operation? If I want to multiply two elements in this external direct product, say these two elements, what do I do? You do the thing you always wanted to do in linear algebra, but Dr. Alk said, no, don't do that. Did you always want to do this in linear algebra or not? Maybe not, but you multiply component-wise. G1 times G1 prime, comma G2 times G2 prime. Where it's assumed that this is the operation in capital G1, and this is the operation in capital G2. Why did I bring up linear algebra? Well, you know, if you pretended these were two-dimensional vectors, it's like we're multiplying two vectors by multiplying their components, which you never do in linear algebra, right? You don't multiply vectors. You can add them. You can multiply them by scalars. You can form their dot product, which is a number, not another vector. You can form their cross product if they're three-dimensional vectors to get another vector. But that cross product was a weird thing. The cross product was kind of a weird thing. Not this simple. In linear algebra, you never did this kind of thing. We're doing it now. Why? Because it makes a group. It makes another example of group that may or may not be useful, but it's another example of a group. This thing, this external direct product, as a set with this binary operation, is a group. As an example, Let's take the external direct product of z2 and z3. We'll just finish, do this example, and that'll be the end of class today. This is, as a set, is the set of all ordered pairs where the first component or coordinate, if you prefer, either word is okay, is an element of z2 and the second one's an element of z3. So I guess the elements are 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 2, and 1, 2. I guess there's 2 times 3, 6 elements. The order of this external direct product is, in fact, the product of the orders of the individual factors, you want to call them? 2 times 3. It's got order 6. Oh, hey, we have a classification theorem. That's 2 times 3, where P is a prime bigger than 2. We had a classification theorem from just a little bit ago that said this has got to be either cyclic, isomorphic to Z6, or isomorphic to D3. Dihedral group of order 6, symmetries of an equilateral triangle. It's got to be isomorphic to one of those two. Which one is it? I hope intuitively you would think the group operation here is going to be abelian, because these are abelian. It's got to be Z6, not D3. Can I come up with a generator? Yeah, I'm going to guess a generator. I hope my guess is not wrong. I'm going to guess. I could make a Cayley table, but for sake of time, I'm not going to. I'm going to guess that Z2 external direct product with Z3 is generated by 1, 1. I could be wrong. I think this is right, though. How would I prove that? I'm not doing powers here. The group operation is addition. I need to add this to itself over and over again and see if I get the entire group. 1, 1 plus itself is what you might say 2, 2. But remember, the group operation in the first component is mod 2 addition, so that's 0. So there's what it simplifies to. If I add it to itself with 3 terms, that's like adding 0, 2 to 1, 1. That's going to give me 1, 3, but the second component is mod 3, so that's really the same as 1, 0. Do it to itself with 4 terms. That's going to give me 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 2, 1, but the first component is done mod 2, so that's really 0, 1. With 5 terms, that's going to be 0, 1 plus 1, 1, which will be 1, 2. If it wasn't clear, I just keep bringing these things over here. Oops. And finally, okay, write all 6. What am I going to get when I do that? Bring the 1, 2 down here and add 1, 1. That gives me 2, 3, but the first component is mod 2 and the second component is mod 3. I'm back to the identity. Therefore, the order of 1, 1 is 6. And therefore, since the order of Z2 external direct product with Z3 is also 6, it must be a generator. Right, and you can also just see it generates every element. Okay, so that's a quick example of an external direct product. In this case, the group operation is addition, because the group operation in the factors of the external direct product is addition as well. I was doing a bunch of adding.